Hey everyone, my name is Ranav and this is Flask In-Depth Tutorials. This is tutorial number 8 and in this tutorial I will be covering the get and post method. So it's been a really long time and I haven't made any video. Actually I was extremely busy with my work. Even though now I am busy, but I'll try my level best to make some videos and help you out guys, okay? And pretty much many things have changed. Okay, so and now I have shifted to Windows 10. Okay, first I was on the Windows 8.1. Okay, so let's begin. So what really is the get and post method? If you have a closer look, the get and post method are like, if you have any experience with the any of the server side scripting languages like the PHP or Node.js, you might be pretty much familiar with the get and post method. But for those who don't know what the get post method is, let me give an explanation. The get method is used to fetch the request, I would say. And the post method is the one which you use in the form, okay? So you post something and a particular action happens. So that is the post method. And these are actually useful in the form, okay? The form validation. This is the important portion of the form validation. So if you focus on this one, you can actually build a complete website with the login and registration and all those things. The post method we can use to interact with the form. Okay, so now this is the basic structure of the Flask. If you don't know, please revert back to the tutorials. Okay, that I have already made. This is the basic structure of the Flask and this is the basic web page. Okay, so now what I will do is I will just show you the basic structure of the get post method and then we will dive into the technicalities. So whenever you want to, first of all, let me just create a form. So I just fast forwarded it. So this is the basic form. Okay, now if you just let me just go over here and show you how the basic form looks. Okay, Flask 8 templates. This is a simple form. Okay, you have to enter a text over here and whenever you click submit, this is the post. Okay, this is actually the post thing. So whenever you click on submit, somewhere the information that you have entered is going to go for the validation. Just keep that in mind. So now what we will do is, with the help of the server side, we are actually going to get hands over it. So whenever you want to use the post method, the get post method, in your app.route mention methods. Okay, and like this, so get and post. Okay, this is the first phase. Okay, so this will actually help your Flask to generate the get and post method. Okay, this is actually, just assume this as the activator. Okay, and in your HTML page over here, just say action. Okay, and in the action, I would say this thing, the route. Okay, this slash, so here it can be actually anything. So if it is like this, you have to type this whole thing. Okay, this is the route. If you don't know the route, the app routing, just check my tutorials. So it's slash and then you will say method. So we are using the post method. Okay, the post method will be used for the validation of the form. Just keep that in mind. Now what we will do is, in here, whenever you want to include the post method, there are two things. So it is request dot method, okay, and request dot form. Okay, so these two terms are really important. Just keep that in mind. The request dot method is actually going to request the method. So whenever you click on the submit, it is the post method and it is going to fetch the method that is the post, and then it is going to request dot form. So the form, it is going to access these elements from the form. And this actually sounds complicated, but let me just type and show you. So we can actually organize it to a greater level, but we will say, so we can actually create a loop. So let's say if request dot method, oops, request.method is equal to post. Okay, so if the method is post, I want to do something. Fine. So what we will do is, if the method is post, that is whenever we are going to click on the submit, okay, we are going to say request.form. Okay, and in this just mention what you have to do. So it is the name, okay, name. So we will say name, and then we want to perform something. So let's say return validation successful. Alright. So whenever I'm going to click on the post, it is going to request.form.names. Okay, so it is going to take that name and it is going to say return validation successful. Okay, so you need a return over here to go hand in hand with this post method, and then you can use the render template. Okay, you have to return some element over here for the basic function. Okay, so let's now just test this thing. It is running. Okay, so this is the form. Now I will enter anything over here and submit, and it says validation successful. So whenever I actually clicked on the submit, what it did, it retrieved the post method, okay, and it selected the form, the name, okay, and it said validation successful. Now we can actually create a form validation, a basic form validation system with this thing. Let me just show you an example. So what I will do is, I will just say input type, okay, and let's say password, and let's say name is equal to pass, okay, and let me just make some spaces over here. Okay, so this basic form is ready. So whenever I am going to enter the name and the password and submit, it is going to give me some output, okay. And it can be anything. It can actually also, you know, redirect to another page whenever the validation is successful. So this is a pretty cool stuff, and it is way much important than anything in the website. Okay, if you are creating a complete website, just keep that in mind. You really need this, and this is going to come in handy. Now what I will do is, whenever the request.form the request.method is equal to post, I want to do something. So we can say request dot form and name, okay, and request dot form password. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, post method is encountered, I'm going to request the name and the password, okay, and let's say if, okay, let's put this in the if, and let's say then I want to do something. So I will just say return validation successful, okay, else if I will say else return validation unsuccessful. Now what actually it is going to do is, if it actually needs the name and the password, both of the things, okay, so even if the one of them has been left blank, it is going to say validation unsuccessful. Okay, so it is going to need both of these for a successful validation. And now I'm just coming out of the loop, okay, and I will just say over here, now I'm going to say return, and let's say so this thing is actually just for this post, okay, and this return render template is for basic. So it is going to say, if the form has both of these, the validation is successful, else the validation is unsuccessful. Now let me just run this thing. Now let's enter the name, and let's leave the password blank, and it is going to say validation unsuccessful. Now what I will do is, I will enter both of them, it says validation successful. And this thing is completely important when it comes to designing a complete website, okay? So you have to focus on this one, and it might sound a little bit confusing, or it might look actually a little bit confusing whenever you are doing it for the first time, but with practice it is going to flow very well. So I'll be posting this code on my GitHub repository, and the link will be down in the description. So I hope that you might have got a little bit idea about the getpost method. So that concludes the tutorial. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.